Hi everyone. Today I'm going to talk about metabolisms, all reactions that we have in our body, including breaking down the complex molecule to the small molecules. Making the new complex molecule from smaller molecules are called metabolism. You will learn about catabolic pathways versus anabolic pathways, exergonic reaction versus an endergonic reaction, cellular respiration, photosynthesis, free energy, entropy or disorder, and spontaneous or non-spontaneous reaction. So, metabolism, I explained it already. These are the example of the catabolic pathways and anabolic path. For example, cellular respiration and hydrolysis a disaccharide to monosaccharide. So, catabolic reactions, when you break the molecule, complex molecule to a small molecules. For example, you have disaccharide here. You want to break it down to monosaccharide. So you need to add water. You remember it's called hydrolysis. When you break the complex molecule or bigger molecule to its components, for example, in this example are two monosaccharides, is an example of the catabolic pathway. Now I want to explain about anabolic reactions, when you build or make or synthesize a complex molecule from a small molecules or simpler molecules. Photosynthesis, I will explain it in a few minutes. I want to explain to you, when you make the fat or triglyceride from one glycerol and three fatty acids is an example of the anabolic reactions. So you remember, for in order to make the fat, you need to have a glycerol and three fatty acid. So the general name for this molecule is called a fatty acid. So if I want to make the bond between glycerol, you remember it's called dehydration synthesis. You need to remove the water. So I will write it down again here. By removing three molecule water, I'm going to make the fat. I will write down the leftover here. Now I make the fat or triglyceride plus three molecule of the water. The point is here, this molecule, this fat molecule, is bigger than each of these components. For example, it's bigger than glycerol and also is bigger than the fatty acid. So when you build or make or synthesize a complex molecule from smaller molecules or simpler molecules, we call it anabolic pathway. So in this slide, you see the, again, definition of the catabolic pathways. It's breaking down the complex molecule into the simpler molecules by releasing energy. So example of the catabolic pathway, cellular respiration. This is the glucose that we get it from food. This is the oxygen that we inhale, and this is the main reason of the cellular respiration, to extract energy from food. And carbon dioxide and water are byproducts of this process. You will learn that this energy is stored in an intermediate molecule is called ATP. Again, the same continue catabolic pathways. I put, as you see here, glucose has many bonds, and each bond carries the chemical energy. When you break the glucose to the carbon dioxide, as you see here, carbon dioxide has less bonds compared to one molecule of the glucose. So that means this molecule has more potential energy or chemical energy. So we have 100 trillion cells in our body. What is the cell? Is the smallest unit of life, and each individual cell can extract the energy of food, that in this example is glucose, and to do the job or work. The process is called cellular respiration. Anabolic pathway, examples are photosynthesis, for example, this plant, and this is the cyanobacteria. Both of them are able to do the photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process that plants or algae are able to capture the carbon dioxide from air. They need water to make the complex molecule, glucose. And this is the byproduct, oxygen. And this is carbon dioxide. But because they are going to make the complex molecule, so it's required energy that they use the sunlight. In this slide, you see the comparison between anabolic pathway and catabolic pathway. So in anabolic pathway, you have a smaller molecules. You are going to make the bonds between them to make a larger molecule by using the energy. How they can get this energy? By catabolic reactions. When you break the complex molecule or larger molecule to the smaller molecules, energy will be released, and this energy can be used for anabolic pathway. Free energy, actually the energy that cell can use it to do work. They use the letter, capital letter of G for free energy. And when you see these triangles, that's mean the change. So triangle, that's mean a change. They use the Gibbs formula. It says delta G was free energy change equal to delta H minus T delta S. So I explained already what does G means. And H, that's mean enthalpy. That's mean the total potential energy in the system or in your molecule. But not all of this potential energy can do the work. So some of them will be released as a heat and disorder. So a letter S represents the entropy or disorder in the system. And T is for temperature. In this example, entropy that you see here, for example, you have glucose. We are going to break it down to the carbon dioxide and water to get the ATP or energy. So when you compare the glucose molecule, that it, as you see here, is highly ordered, and also we have only one glucose. When you break it down to the small molecules, you increase the disorder or S. So if I ask you to calculate delta S is going to be S2 minus S1. S2, that's mean products, entropy of the products or disorder, minus entropy or disorder of the reactants. In this example, because S2, we have more disorder in the product side, is greater than S1, so delta S is positive. So in cellular respiration or in catabolic pathway, because you are going to make more disorder at the end, delta S is greater than 0. Enthalpy, I already explained it, they use the letter H, and it represents the total bond energy or potential energy. You know, scientists, they find out that when delta G is negative, that means the reaction is exergonic reaction, is spontaneous. That means it happens by itself. Delta G is positive, reaction is called endergonic reaction. That means you need to put or enter energy into the system, and it's called non-spontaneous. This bar graph shows the exergonic reaction. Delta G is negative, and I want to explain it why delta G is negative. So delta G is equal to G2 minus G1. 2 always for products, free energy of the products minus free energy of the reactant. So this is my G1 and this is my G2. Delta G, because G2 is smaller than G1, so delta G in this example is negative. If it's hard for you to find out, you can just use numbers. For example, if this is 2 units, and for example, if this is 6 units, 2 minus 6 is going to be negative 4, so delta G is negative. When delta G is negative, the reaction is called spontaneously. Or when you go down the hill, energy will be released. Reaction example for cellular respiration. Here, example of the endergonic reaction, photosynthesis. Delta G here is positive. Delta G, positive. Delta G is equal to G2 minus G1. As you see here, G2 is greater than G1. As you see here, G2 greater than G1, so delta G is positive and is non-spontaneous. You need to enter energy into the system. The reason plants, they need sunlight to do the photosynthesis. So now you need to review what you have learned so far. Is cellular respiration endergonic or exergonic reaction? Is exergonic reaction, it happens in our body spontaneously. And photosynthesis is an example of the, an endergonic reaction. Now, I want to compare both pathways. Cellular respiration, we need good food, oxygen. We exhale carbon dioxide, we release water, and ATP or energy. Call it cellular respiration. The bar graph shows that reactant. This is reactant, this is product. Energy leave the system. This is G1, this is G2, delta G is negative. Form are the same. This is G1, this is G2. These two graphs are the same. This is bar graph and this is linear graph. So this is G for free energy. Delta S is positive. If this is negative, entropy change is going to be positive, and I already explained it, that here you have more entropy compared to the glucose molecule. It's called spontaneously. It's called a spontaneous reaction. On the other hand, you will write the same things, plants and algae able to capture the carbon dioxide, use the water, and use the sunlight also to make the sugar and oxygen molecule. So this process is called photosynthesis. In photosynthesis, the bar graph, free energy of the reactants is smaller than the products. So you need to put, when you go up the hill, you need to put energy into the system. The reason they use sunlight. The linear graph this way. This is G1, they are the same. And this is G2, and they need to put energy into the system. Delta G for in anabolic pathway is positive, greater than zero, and delta S is negative. The reaction is non-spontaneous. Now I want to show you demonstrations. Imagine this cookie is a macromolecule, and as you see here is highly ordered, and also I have only one. So I'm breaking it down into small pieces. By breaking down the macromolecule like a starch or protein into their monomers, we increase the entropy or disorder. And as you notice, I spend a little time, you know, and energy to break down the complex molecule or big molecule into small pieces. But if you ask me to make the same cookie, I cannot do it in a few seconds. It's required more energy and time. And this is happening in our body. And my hand works as an enzyme. What is an enzyme? You need to watch my next video.
Thank you for watching this video.